Alexander. Today we are having Jordan Maxwell, a famous American researcher who has been looking into the occult for decades, for over 60 years. Hello, Jordan. Thanks for coming on the show. Please introduce yourself.
Thank you for having me on, Alexander. You're great. Fascinating to see you and to be on the show with you. Always happy to be able to see you.
And I'm happy to see you. So, Jordan, we see it in the news a lot now, and it's the coronavirus and how it's breaking in China and how it's causing people to get sick and die with a 15% kill rate, with 30,000 people infected, and it's coming into the United States. So can you tell us how this virus started?
Well, I don't really know how it started, but the Chinese ambassador to the United States, he said on television, he said it would not surprise him if this was actually a virus developed by the military as a military movement against another country. And he said it could be the Chinese military developed this to affect the Americans and to hurt America. Or it could be the Americans developed this virus to hurt China. But he said, it would not surprise me if these were developed by military intelligence and military medical. And I thought the same thing when I first heard it. When I heard the word coronavirus, that was a tip off to me. Boy, I thought to myself, I know exactly what this is. It's a military virus. And it's a communist China military virus, or a Russian, either Russian or Chinese communist. I think it's probably Chinese or American. It could be American equally. It could be an American disease developed by the American's military to affect the whole world. Or it could be China's, communist China's military medical experiment to affect the whole world. Why? Because when I heard the word coronavirus, that was a tip-off. If you know what these words mean, that was a tip-off that this was a communist disease developed in China. Because when the Soviet Union was, when the Soviet Union, Communist Russia, was first founded, their national coat of arms was a sunrise with the sun rays over right. the earth.
Yeah.
The sun rays, when you see a picture with the rays are referred to as a corona. A corona is the sun rays. A child draws a picture of the sun, they draw the spokes, you know, around the sun. That's the sun rays, all right? Well, the sun rays are called coronas. And then when I heard coronavirus, yeah, corona is a word I'm well aware of in relation to communist technology. Corona means the sun rays of the dawn of a new day, sun, which was a symbol for the Soviet Union. And so when I heard corona, I think communist. That's me, because I'm well aware of the history of the Soviet Union, the communist movement, 1848 to 1849. I know all about the secret societies that finance and organize and direct communism out of America and England. And when I heard the word corona, that was my first thought. This is a communist disease developed in communist China's military. No doubt in my mind about it.
So that's pretty major that this has to do with the rising of a new day. So this basically symbolizes a rising of a new pandemic that is going to...
That's right. People. That's exactly right. This is the tip-off to the rising of a new disease that's coming on the world from communist China. And it could be possibly coming from the U.S. and not from communist China, but it is definitely a communistic words that are being used. Corona is a communistic word in my book because it has to do with the symbolism of world communism. The world communism is symbolized, and you will see it when you come to my conference that I'm going to be speaking at. That's what it's going to be on. I'm going to show you all the documents proving it. Then you'll understand better what I'm saying now. Once you see it yourself, you will see the sunrise over the earth is called a corona.
Yeah.
And then when I hear a coronavirus, well, it's the sunrise of a dawn of a new day. A virus is coming to affect the whole world on both sides.
So we see that happening. We see the symbolism involved with the name coronavirus. So do you think, why would China start it in their own country, though? Would they want to kill off some of their own people? Or do you think this was actually started by the New World Order / shadow government?
Yeah, I think maybe it might be the shadow government doing it to China and America. Because China is one half the world, as far as I'm concerned, is China.
Yeah.
China is big. And so I'm sure that the Illuminati masters who own the earth, and don't ever think they are not actually Illuminati masters that own the earth. They do. They actually own the globe. And they don't care who they kill or who they put to death. And so I'm thinking that this shadow government behind America and behind China and Russia, where it was a communist country, they want to begin to kill off. We've known that. We've been hearing about that for many years, how the Illuminati masters of this world want to kill off the populations. Too many people. They're eating too much.
Yeah.
It costs too much. They just eat and eat and eat. And reproduce babies and just keep reproducing and eating and reproducing. We've had enough of that crap. We don't need them to reproduce more millions and millions of people that we have to feed, and we don't have enough food for the people that are alive today. Why the hell do we need to keep reproducing more people? Just keep having babies and babies and more babies and more babies until one day there's going to be billions and billions of children and babies being born with no food, no clean water, no clean air, nothing of any value.
Yeah, because that's the only way they can keep their monopoly with the oil monopoly, because they could have a clean earth, they could have a clean world if they let out the free energy, but they don't
want... Of course, they don't want the free energy. That's the one thing they don't want is free energy.
Yeah, they don't want to lose their big monopoly. So another big thing, this coronavirus has already led to the quarantine of over 400 million people. Half of China's population is now quarantined. And we see Xi Jinping, the dictator of China, not being seen for weeks. He is hiding out because he knows this virus is something big.
Yeah, and I'm sure of it, because it's obviously a military, medical operation to ultimately to introduce into human society some kind of a virus that's going to kill off millions of people. And it wouldn't surprise me if that's what's coming.
Yeah, and this virus has already 800 people dead, and with a 15% kill rate, it passes from mother to baby as well. When the mother is pregnant and they have the baby gets it. We've already been shown that with women who had the coronavirus and gave birth. And we also see Chinese whistleblowers dying mysteriously.
Mysteriously.
Yeah, when they try to say that there's way more people infected with this disease. It's already killed more people than SARS, and it's just exploding.
Well, once you see my presentation I've worked 50 years on about the symbolism, the symbols and the occult or hidden symbols and emblems of political power in the Soviet Union, and what those symbols represented according to their own books and according to their own educational records, what the symbols mean, it shows that the world communism is now in a position to take over the whole earth. And this is what they are now talking about, the coronavirus.
Yeah.
The corona is a sunburst, the sunburst.
Right.
And that's the symbol for world communism, is a sunburst. It's called the sun corona. And so when I hear about coronavirus, logically it tells me, yeah, these people are still at it. They're going to kill off. They've been talking about killing off the population. Well, this is going to do it.
It's a world takeover. And we also see some Indian nationalists from India, scientists who have just conducted a study saying that this virus causes AIDS. Airborne AIDS is basically the coronavirus, what these researchers have been saying.
Yeah.
So this will keep people on medication also, so Big Pharma makes more money.
Right.
And also, if they have a forced vaccination for the whole world,
well, that's right.
A ton of money, and that vaccination may be a slow kill for the people.
It is, and you just remember that. You remember what the scientists in India and the doctors in India are saying, because I'm going to show you something when I'm speaking in Laughlin,
Nevada.
Laughlin, Nevada, next week. I'm going to show you something from India. You're not going to believe the symbolism in India. When you see the corona, communism for India. Corona.
So everyone really needs to stay safe and get some canned food in case they find out that the coronavirus is spreading in their area. Because this could be like the bubonic plague where you have to stay hiding for a while. So, Jordan, I really thank you for everything you've stated. And everyone who can, please join Jordan Maxwell's Research Society at jordanmaxwellshow.com and attend his conference at Laughlin, Nevada that's coming up. Can you give us the day that starts?
It starts on the 15th of this month, next week. I think it's this coming Saturday is when it begins for 7 days. It's going to be a 7-day conference with speakers coming from all over the world to talk about all the dark stuff that nobody knows anything about. And that's why they've invited me to speak. And I've got a 2-hour presentation I'm going to do on the coronavirus and show where that word comes from and what it means and what's going on in India that they're not telling you. I'll show you exactly what the symbols are, and that's how they're explaining what they're doing. And we know we've been hearing for years about how the elite among the human population on the earth want to get rid of so many millions of people. Well, yeah. If this is what I think it is, this may be the one that's going to do it.
And you're also going to be presented with an award also for all the work you've done for the human race and trying to expose these evil and corrupt people for who they are and what they stand for. So, Jordan, I really thank you for being on the show, and I would like to have another interview with you soon.
I would love to do it. Always be delighted to be on the show with you. Thank you again.
Thank you, Jordan.
Bye-bye.